Hello, this is the RPG Chick. Welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect Andromeda. Let's go check out some new solar systems. We had the movie night last night. And a moment with Suvi. That was very nice. We got new systems. Before I start going probing this thing, gotta check out all the new systems, because that's the way I roll, so... We may or may not get to anything. I predict we'll be able to check out all the new systems and probe the thing. Probe the Scourge. We got two more probes.
Scourge really left its mark on these systems.
It's getting dense in the space beyond. Better be careful.
Is there danger here?
Anomaly detected.
An anomaly. Alright, let's start from the furthest planet out. This is a Meos system, and, Huiton? Is that how you say it? Check out all these planets. And see what there is to see. Another one that looks like an eye. All these eyeball planets.
Anomaly on sensors.
I see you! Probe the retina. Huiton's hydrogen and nitrogen atmosphere is notable for its unique weather patterns. Storms begin and end here with almost mechanical consistency. What do we find? Oh, this? A storm? Oh, it's hard to zoom in on, huh?
Deploying probe. Anomaly found.
Yep, storm. Radius 8,847 kilometers, wind speed 486 kilometers per hour. Could you imagine being stuck in the middle of that? Rotation counterclockwise. This storm does not fit Huiton's usual patterns. It appears to be the result of a comet impact that occurred within the past decade. You got experience from it.
Anomaly on sensors.
Check out the anomaly last. Let's check out... How do you say these names? Asquiu? I don't know. Cool. Looks like a cross between the moon and Saturn. Gold and silver abound in a thin ring surrounding this icy world, likely caused by numerous meteor impacts over hundreds of millennia. Okey-doke.
Anomaly on sensors.
Alright. Next one in. Sictin. I'm having trouble saying all these names. Oh, cool. They've got a special thing anomaly in the rings, I guess?
Anomaly detected.
Yep. Despite its size, this gas giant was not visible from the Milky Way galaxy during early surveys. Whether it was somehow missed or affected by the Scourge is unclear.
Probes launched.
What we
got
found?
A reading from the asteroid belt.
Oh. Satellite ID unknown, corrupted. Power readings 13.5%. System report, severe damage to all systems. Status inactive. This Andromeda Initiative satellite appears to be programmed to study Sictin, but many of its key components have been stripped away. By the Ket, I wonder? Get some Milky Way research data. That looks like a battery.
Anomaly on sensors.
Next is Vale. In Valen's name.
Anomaly
Well, that's pretty. The veil's silica and aluminum surface is spotted with anomalous materials that defy our scans. Reaching these materials through the scorching irradiated atmosphere will be the challenge of a generation. Oh, they can have at it.
Anomaly detected.
I have other things to do. H088. Ran out of names again. Endless flat deserts cover H-088's surface under a sky suffused with lightning. A single great gouge, like an abandoned quarry, suggests a mining effort by ancient visitors.
Anomaly on sensors.
I think we've seen all the planets. What's this anomaly? Where are you? Right there.
Getting a scan.
Yeah, what is it? What do you find? Comet revolver? I can't decide if it's a comet or a kind of gun. Let's go help it decide. You're a comet, buddy. Nucleus 5 kilometers. Coma cloud, 29,300 kilometers. Current tail, 329,000 kilometers. Engarran records confirm this comet collided with observational equipment at several points, causing it to spin off course. It follows a doomed orbit. 21 titanium. And that's it for Meos. Continuing. Where are we? We're here? Oh, I've been to Farrowing and Gerator. Lion? Go to Lion.
We're a long way out here.
I'll say. There's quite the view of the Scourge.
Wow. Pretty cool.
Anomaly on sensors.
Alright. Land system, pass 32. I don't know why. I like to start with the outermost planet, work my way in. I don't know why. Kind of a habit. Ever since, I don't know. The Mass Effect, the first Mass Effect, or Mass Effect 2?
Anomaly on sensors.
PAS 32 is, according to our best calculations, positioned at a safe distance from the Scourge, such that observations made from PAS 32 are not widely distorted by Scourge effects. Well, that's always a good thing. What am I looking for? This thing? That's above the surface, isn't it?
Deploying probe. Satellite detected.
Yep. Satellite ID. Unknown. Power readings 41.1%. System report. Sensors functional and active. Well, that's a better look from there, isn't it? Status operational. This satellite appears to use Andromeda Initiative technology and is oriented to monitor the Scourge. How and why it was placed, however, is a mystery. But I got some research data.
Anomaly on sensors.
Yeah, checking out the anomaly last. Everodan? Interesting name. There's a little thing all the way out here in the middle of nowhere. I Images from the unmanned flyover of Everodan brought its gemstone mountains to Angaran attention centuries ago. The planet was an icon of alien beauty, now generally forgotten. We'll remember you. We'll try.
Anomaly on sensors.
Okay, second planet from the sun, Paz 29. Paz 29's constant downpour of sulfuric acid rain evaporates before touching the planet's surface, where streams of lava are spewed regularly by active volcanoes.
Mm-hmm. I'm picking up something.
Okay, sweetie. One moment. Paz 40A. And then we'll check out this anomaly that Suvi sees. Or is detecting. That was the sound of us going through the dust field there. The sun looks really cool, doesn't it? I'm trying to see it. Just look at it. Look at the flares and stuff. Pretty cool. Look at this little thing. Paz 40's moon likely came into being through a massive asteroid impact millennia ago, creating both the planet's rings and Paz 40A. We found a crater.
Probes launched. We've got a crater.
We've got the crater. Hypervelocity impact crater. Rim diameter 357 kilometers. Depth approximately 2.3 kilometers. Ejecta mineral deposits. Buried at the center of this crater is an ancient metal object that appears to be some sort of torpedo. It seems Paz 40A was caught in the crossfire of a space battle centuries or millennia ago. Caught in a crossfire. Got experience. Alright.
Anomaly on sensors.
Let's check out your anomaly.
Probes launched. Got a reading from the asteroid belt.
Starship wreckage. Let's check it out. I like these exploration segments. Don't hit a rock, Kalo. There it is. Looks like it says SOS. It'd be 505, though. Of course, it won't be in... SOS wouldn't be engraved on the friggin' thing. Ship identification, TARB-04. Ship name unknown. Crew complement 1. Status not available. The resident of this escape pod has been deceased for some time, but her records reveal that she was one of the Nexus exiles. Her passion for the Andromeda Initiative's scientific goals never faded. She died here on one final exploratory mission. Oh, how sad. Got a bunch of stuff. Scrap. 100%. Next system. Vaotessa. Mm. Vaotessa.
There were once hundreds of books and vids about this system.
Really?
I thought there might be people here. Alien life was fascinating to dream about. That was before the kit.
Huh. Yeah, you found out alien life was not so hot after all. Until you met us, of course. I mean, we're awesome. But it is really interesting looking. I mean, what are these swirling vapors coming from the sun? Or being drawn into the sun? Okay. So we got Precagni? Precagni? Well, she didn't find any anomaly in this system. Again, looks like the moon crossed with Saturn. Named for an Angaran novel about a never-ending winter, Prakanyi is a strong candidate for mechanized and automated water ice mining. Alrighty.
I'm picking up something.
Well, she is picking up something. Either I didn't notice her say it, I might be so used to hearing her say it that's just background noise. Sorry, Suvi. Or, yeah, it's because Jal was talking. And she didn't want to interrupt him. She's so polite. Stodran planet.
Anomaly detected.
Okay. The largest moon of the gas giant... Okay, so not a planet. Moon. Of the gas giant Erivosna? Stodran was at one time believed by Angaran astronomers to contain pockets of water, ice, and perhaps microbial life. I wonder if we'll find that with our anomaly here.
Probes launched. Detecting what's left of a ship.
Oh, well, that's definitely Cat. Satellite ID unknown. Power reading 75.1%. System reports sensors functional and active. Status operational. This Cat satellite appears to be monitoring the Vaotessa system's asteroid belt, recording detailed scans from a safe distance. We should destroy these things when you find them, right? Either we can't, or it's implied that we are. I don't know.
Anomaly on sensors.
Why wouldn't we destroy them? Alright. What's this? I can't see the first word. Let's go here first then, so I can see it. Fensayat. Innermost planet. Yeah, the exclamation mark is in the way. Can you believe that? Fensayat's crushingly heavy gravity may be more dangerous than its molten seas. It was named for a mythical Angaran warlord. Yeah, it doesn't seem like a nice place to live.
I'm picking up something.
I still can't... Nedeker? Because now the ship's in the way. I'll see you in a second. What, about 3 or 4 seconds?
Something.
Okay, it's called what? Nedeker, right. Though Nedeker is arid and cold, liquid water can be found in its underground seas and during rare rains. Multiple Angaran colonies were planned, none were ever founded. Well.
Probes launched. I found something.
Biomatter growth. Classification plant. Origin Nedeker, or possibly off-world. Quarantine recommendation, level 3. This vast forest appears to be sustained by an enormous underground reservoir. The individual plants seem to be linked, almost acting as a single organism. Couldn't be the Thorian, could it? Huh. Get some experience. 80%.
I'm picking up something.
Oh, that's right. She was picking up something. Something right here.
Deploying probe. Got a reading from the asteroid belt.
A vessel? We must investigate. Ship identity and name and crew complement, all unknown, status not available. This Cat survey vessel appears to have been searching the asteroid belt for life before it suffered an engine failure. A select few rock samples have miraculously survived. And we got, power supplies and stuff, scrap. Now we're complete. Okay, next is Bosavay.
Energetic star.
Cool.
Deploying radiation and emission screens. Our sensors should be safe.
Good to hear. Okay.
I'm picking up something.
But of course you are. Bosavay system. Let's check out PAS 51. What's that line? Reflection of the other line? From the star? I'm gonna get a look at this star. Very coppery, coppery world. Many of the conditions on PAS 51 are amenable to the development of life, microbial at least, but its searing temperatures are an obstacle not easily overcome. Oh, we were right there.
Probes launched. I found something.
It's a mountain. Height is 8.8 kilometers, origin tectonic. Water vapor escapes from cracks in this mountain, suggesting that somewhere deep underground, where temperatures are far cooler, a reservoir may exist. If life forms exist on PAS 51, it will be there. It's always 270 XP. Exactly. No more, no less.
I'm picking up something.
Okay, we want... Typhrondra. Okay. Typhrondra's weather is uncommonly tranquil for a gas giant. Its clouds and electrical storms move in slow, predictable patterns worthy of further study. Okay.
I'm picking up something.
Next is Isheng. Poor Suvi has to remind us every time. You know I'm picking up something, right? Oh, hold on, hold on. Another moon, Saturn. Auroral flashes are visible at most times of day from the cobalt surface of Isheng. The electromagnetic effects may interfere with communications. That's all right. We're just gonna shout across the bridge. We'll hear each other.
I'm picking up something.
Last planet, PAS 60, innermost planet. Got to look at the sun, maybe. It's very energetic. Yeah, look at that. Blue star. The hottest star, right? I think we could go bluer than that, but yeah, it's pretty hot. The seething radiation of the Bosavay sun keeps portions of PAS 60 molten at all times. Attempting to land here would be extremely inadvisable. Yeah, don't worry. Not gonna be doing that.
Anomaly detected.
Bloop.
Supplying probe. I found something.
You found element zero. Yay, element zero. What was it? Mass Effect 2? Whenever we found element zero on a planet, we're like, oh yeah. Yeah, look at that. It's so pretty. Element zero ordinarily forms in the aftermath of a supernova. This pocket appears to be naturally occurring, but the circumstances are wrong. Could the scourge be a factor? Well, either way, we got 34 of it. And another system complete. Alright, what else? Everything else is up this way. We'll check out Vaar. We'll go here last and scan that scourge there. See you later, Izo. Was it Vaar? V-A-A-R?
Zuby, keep an eye on those sensors.
I always do.
Yeah, I was gonna say.
I know, it's just... this is a dicey sector. Better to be ready.
Zuby was... on sensors.
See? She was born ready. Got a lot of planets here. So she's gonna be saying that quite a bit. H-147, check out that first. It's so pretty, though. Again, yeah, is it coming from the star? These gases? It's like in orbit around, but twirling into, spiraling into the star. Boosh.
Anomaly on sensors.
See, she's on it, Callow. She's on it. Frozen ethane covers H-174. The ice sheets interrupted only by low mountains and shallow craters. Thanks to dust clouds in the inner system, little sunlight reaches this world. What are we looking for? Running out of space here. Must be this thing.
Probes launched. I found something.
Starship wreckage. Ship identity Gord-01. Ship name unknown. Crew complement 1, status not available. The deceased outcast inhabitant of this escape pod appears to have fled a battle at Meos in the inner system. Oh, really? Okay, bunch of scrap.
I'm picking up something.
Yep, you are. H-173. Great oceans of ethane and thin sheets of water ice cover the surface of H-173. Ice mining might be possible here, but there are surely richer sources on more agreeable worlds. Yes, there may be, but don't call me Shirley.
Anomaly detected.
Next, third in, H-171. H-171 is sheltered from the heat of Vaar's sun by large dust clouds in the inner solar system. The result is a glittering orb of frozen ammonia and tin.
I'm picking up something.
Okay, next is Morgoth. Ooh, cool name, I like that. It's almost like Morgoth from... Morgoth is a... well, not only in the name of a death metal band. They got their name from Lord of the Rings, I believe, and Morgoth is a very frightful creature. I'm pretty sure it's from Lord of the Rings. Morgoth's extraordinarily dangerous surface is of less interest than its ring system. Its inner ring is primarily dust and rock. The outer ring is composed of large chunks of water ice.
Anomaly detected.
Okay, we got one more planet. Meos. This is where the battle occurred. Aforementioned. On the last planet. cool.
Anomaly detected.
An outcast mineral mining camp has been recently demolished here. A fragmentary distress call describes the attackers as other exiles. There are no survivors. Oh, that when you randomly come across planets and sometimes you could land on them and you'd have a mission there because it'd be a distress call.
Probe away.
Kind of missed that.
Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Graphite. This graphite mineral deposit should prove useful to the initiative for manufacturing. Well, we found 128 of it. Hopefully that will be worth it.
I'm picking up something.
Okay, let's see what she's picking up.
Probe away. Detecting what's left of a ship.
Yeah. Ship identity unknown. Ship name Local Boy? Is that printed on the ship? Local Boy. Crew complement 14. Status not available. This shuttle appears to have limped away from a battle. Logs indicate the crew, now deceased, came to Vaar to raid an outcast mining camp. The attempt must have ended badly. You got a bunch of scrap from it. Okay. And that's it for Vaar. Now I'm pretty sure... Yeah, two systems left. Next, Ratul. Ratul! Just checking. Yeah, all these others with the Scourge fragment have been explored. Okay, Ratul. Whole lot of systems going on.
Rumor has it this is quite the lawless region. No place to get stranded.
Stranded? Why would you even bring that up?
She's funny. Alright. Govox Folly. Interesting name. Who's Govok, and why is this his folly?
Ish. I'm picking up something.
Okay, Govok's folly. The Scourge and some unusual orbital mechanics leave Govok's folly icebound at night and boiling during the day. The outcast Govok attempted to take advantage of this to little avail. How would you take advantage of it? Are we gonna find out here?
Probes launched. I found something.
Govok's vessel? Ship identity and name unknown. Crew complement unknown. Estimate 5 to 8. Status not available. This Ket dropship appears to have been departing Govok's folly when it was hit by weapons fire. Perhaps Govok is still alive and active after all. Scratch. Okay. Next. But she doesn't detect anything in this one. Okay. H-494. Whoa, that looks cool. Milky Way survey suggests two gas giants were present in Ratul. Could the Scourge have collapsed them into a single world in less than 6 centuries? Or is something else at work? No idea, man. No idea. Next is Hibaro. Pretty. Looks like Earth.
I'm picking up something.
Only the blue of the oceans is really blue. Hibaro has adapted bizarrely to the Scourge. For about a third of its orbital period, the Scourge's effects permit plant life to flourish. At all other times, Hibaro boils in the Ratul sun.
Probes launched. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Iron. This large iron deposit can be rapidly mined and put to good use. 53 of it. Next up, Kizrada. Kizrada! Kizrada has its own song, you see. It's always sung so badly and weirdly that everyone just decides to forget about it. Oh, very pretty planets in this system. The Scourge has caused massive electromagnetic disturbances in Kizrada's atmosphere. Like what was blinking was part of our display. Avoiding any closer proximity to the planet is strongly advised. Well, we'll just have to look on its prettiness from afar. And the last planet, Insaron. Saron's nitrogen and carbon monoxide atmosphere is gradually being stripped away by Ratul's sun, leaving the barren surface utterly unprotected from the sun's radiation. How sad. Alright, done with this system. Time to move on to our last system, Rohvir, and there will be a Scourge, part of the Scourge to probe here as well. We have more than two. I mean, we only have to find two, but there's more than that highlighted on our map.
Any other ships would venture out this far.
Yeah, well,
it's our job to be first.
Not everyone's like us. So,
I'm picking up something.
Yeah, look at these strange elliptical orbits here. Warius. So yeah, I'm guessing we only have to just pick two. Out of like four left, I think? In the whole cluster? Warius is inhabited by simple herds of methane breathers, struggling to find shelter against the cold. It may be the Scourge's effects that have pushed these creatures to near extinction. Methane breathers. Herds, okay. I guess they're not intelligent, just herd-like creatures.
Anomaly on sensors.
Okay, next. Momirus. We'll check out the anomalies and probe the Scourge last. Yeah, longer episode. I thought it would be done quicker. Takes a while to look at all this stuff.
Anomaly on sensors.
It looks like aluminum foil covering it, doesn't it? Momirus appears to have been stripped of a breathable atmosphere by the Scourge phenomena over the past century. What remains is a barren sphere of boron and carbon. What do we find here?
Deploying probe. Tracking a huge mineral deposit.
Aluminum! Yeah, it does look like aluminum, yep. a valuable light metal. This deposit is close to the surface and relatively easy to mine. We found 93 of it, which isn't very much.
Anomaly detected.
Okay, next. Strange orbits. H-169. On a cursory visual inspection, this massive planet appears almost Earth-like, but its incredibly heavy gravity and crushing atmosphere make colonization a long shot. Okey-doke.
Anomaly on sensors.
Okay, so we are here. Alright, so two more. H-162. Okay. Much of H-162's unusual coloration comes from what appears to be a sort of algae. The organism pervades the dense, moist atmosphere floating on the wind. Ugh. Never mind. Floating atmosphere. I mean floating algae. Is something I'd rather avoid. H-080. Massive sandstorms thrash H-080's surface day in and day out, wearing once mighty mountain ranges down to smooth nubs over millennia. Well, they can be mighty nubs, you know. Just because they're smooth doesn't mean they can't be mighty.
Anomaly detected.
And small. Anomaly... Let's see what we got.
Probe away.
This is one of the chosen data collection nav points. We should release a probe.
Yes, we should. Well, it's freaky the way it, like, moved like that.
Data collection probe ready for placement.
Spatial anomaly related to the scourge. Dark energy discernible from radiation, gravitational and radiation effects. Composition ice, mineral debris, element zero, and unknown materials. Warning, intense levels of radiation detected. A shielded probe will last long enough to collect data, however, and can still be used to collect data. Alright.
Data collection commencing.
Okay. We got something else in the system.
Anomaly on sensors.
See, she's on it, Callow.
Probes launched. I found something.
The starship wreckage. Crashed against the scourge, I bet. Yep. Well, it's so freaky the way it moves. Ship identity and name unknown. Crew complement zero assumed. Status not available. A remnant fighter seemingly impaled on a tendril of scourge. Astonishingly, certain self-repair mechanisms appear to be intact, though the vessel will never be whole again. We can get scrap from it. Yeah, hard to put that back together. Now we're done. Now those are all the unexplored systems. Pretty sure I'm not missing anything. pick one. Let's go back to Erickson's system. One of the first systems we ever went to. We started with, what's Pythias? I'm not sure what system we started out of. Pfeiffer, maybe? Alright, let's go to Erickson. If I can only go to one more, we'll go to Erickson. It was like 6 months ago I went to that place. 8 months.
Anomaly detected.
Yep.
Probe away.
Go get it.
Scourge activity is common in this area. Might be worth planting a probe.
True that. Vinland starship wreckage. Markland. Yeah, I guess we didn't find much here.
Approaching one of the ideal probe locations, Pathfinder.
Oh, goody. See what you got.
The data collection probe is prepped whenever you're ready, Ryder.
A dense pocket of scourge matter, a probe deposited within the center of the formation, may be used to collect data.
Probe deployed. Pathfinder, I have analyzed the results of the scourge energy pattern model.
Oh, goody.
And?
This is how you get Meridian. Access the bridge whenever you're ready.
I'm at the bridge. Speak to crew about scourge research. Okay. Guess that'll be next episode. Let's say 11 meters this way. Oh, really? I never noticed that there before. Alright. We've been running long enough, though. Anything new? Yeah, speak to the crew. That will be next episode. Alright, thanks for watching, guys. See you next time. And always, seek adventure.